the heart and the actions. So the heart has to be sound upon the correct Islamic belief, upon this enthusiasm to do good and obey. Obey Allah and obey the Messenger. Atiyu Allah wa atiyu Rasul. Wa man yushaqiqi Rasula min ba'di ma tabayyana lahu al-huda wa yattabi ghayra sabilil mu'minin nuwallihi ma tawalla wa nuslihi jahannama wa sa'at masira. In the first ayah, whom obey Allah and obey the Messenger. In the second ayah, whomsoever contends with the Messenger after the guidance has been conveyed to him, then he chooses a path other than the path of the Sahaba, then Allah will leave him in the path that he has chosen and burn him, roast him in the hellfire for contending with the Prophet in his obedience and for opposing the companions of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So in conclusion, we'll finish with an ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَا يَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْعَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلِفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ وَلَا يُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمْ الَّذِي ارْتَدَى لَهُمْ وَلَا يُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا. Stop there for a moment. Let me translate that one for you first before we mention the second part, which is a condition for the first part. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in this ayah in the Quran, this is a promise from your Lord. A promise from Allah. Does Allah break His promises? Abadan. Never. A promise from your Lord. A pledge from Him. For those amongst you who have iman. Iman, my brothers and sisters, is based upon the Islamic aqidah. Not based upon something floating through the air that just comes and embeds itself in your chest. This is not iman. Iman is based upon the correct Islamic creed, belief, aqidah, that which the Sahaba were upon. Knowing your tawheed. Knowing the sunnah, knowing the status of the Prophet, knowing the status of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and so on and so forth. Knowing who Allah is, His names, His attributes, and the principles related to it. That whomsoever amongst you has iman, the Prophet sallallahu Allah says in this ayah, a pledge from your Lord, for those amongst you have iman, wa amilu salihat, and you have righteous actions. We are not murjiya. We are not this deviated sect who believes that iman is just in the heart. Brother, how many times I've heard this? Back in England, from our Muslim communities, they'll say, brother, don't talk to me about my sunnah. My heart is clean. I don't have to pray. My heart is clean. I don't have to give in charity. My heart is clean. It's okay. I know that I drink, but wallahi, my heart is clean. This ideology, the ideology of one of the worst of the deviated sects in Islam, known as the Murjiya, who believe that so long as your heart is okay, you don't have to do anything upon the limbs. Deviated belief for which a person will be cast into the hellfire if he does not repent from it and come back from it. So we have to be careful. For those of you who have iman, knowledge of the creed, and they work righteous deeds, that Allah will give them khilafa in the ard. Who will Allah give it to? Anybody or these groups of people? Iman, righteous deeds, that Allah will give you establishment, meaning the khilafa in the ard, in the earth, just as He gave it to those who came before them. And Allah will establish for them their religion. Establish their religion for them. The religion that Allah is pleased with. The deen of Allah, not the deen of the sects. Not the deen of the deen or the religion of the various factions. But His religion will be established. Allah will establish His religion. The religion of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. The religion of the early Salaf. This religion is the religion that Allah will establish for you. Just as he established for those who came before them. And then Allah mentions that Allah will change their condition from a condition of fear and terror that they used to live in and replace it with amna, with aman, with security, tranquility. Allah will replace that for them. The terror and the fear will be replaced. For whom? For those who believe and work righteous deeds. Then Allah mentions two further conditions. Allah mentions, يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. That so long as they worship me alone, and they do not associate any partners. In this ayah, and then Allah mentions, of course, وَمَنْ كَفَرَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. And whomsoever disbelieves thereafter, then indeed they are the transgressing sinful ones. But look at this ayah. Four conditions. First condition, that Allah has mentioned, you must have the right, correct iman, meaning the correct Islamic belief. Secondly, that you must work righteous deeds. Thirdly, يَعْبُدُونَنِي, that you worship Him alone. As Allah mentions, worship Me alone. Fourthly, that you do not associate any partners with him in worship. What will Allah do? If you have these four things, Allah will establish for you your Islam in the earth. Allah will establish the Islamic state, as they call it, the Khilafah. Give the Muslims establishment. But not just wishing for it. Not just watching CNN and ABC and watching the internet. This is what happening in Iraq. This is what happening in Afghanistan. Ask yourselves the question, what am I doing? Am I following the Sunnah? Do I have knowledge? Do I have enthusiasm? Do I have enthusiasm for practicing and learning? Or am I just one of those individuals that goes through life like a leaf that goes through the wind? And like Imam al-Barbahari mentions with regard to the rabble of the Muslims. And they are the worst of the Muslims amongst the awam, the rabble. That whichever way the wind blows, they go with it. This is not the attitude of the Muslim. The wind goes east, you flow east. The wind goes west, you go west. And reactionary. Something happens on the TV, you see some Muslims being killed. Tears come from the eyes. 20 minutes later, you're living your life again as it was 20 minutes earlier. This is the Muslim. This is the enthusiasm of the Muslim. The Muslim is the one who recognizes completely and totally that there are things that need to be done. And they begin with knowledge and action. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. And we ask in conclusion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us, guides you and guides myself to His pleasure, and guides us to understanding His deen, and guides us to have this enthusiasm to act upon the deen of Allah and upon the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. وعليكم السلام.